Okay, in this short video, I'm going to explain how the Monte Carlo Tree Search algorithm works so that you can see how to do it and implement it yourself. I'm going to give you a worked example, and then there's going to be an assignment based on extending that example with further rollouts. So Monte Carlo Tree Search works in four phases. There's a tree traversal phase using the UCB1 formula. Then there's a node expansion phase where you add extra nodes into the tree. This is followed by a rollout phase. That's where you do a random simulation of the game or the problem that you're solving in order to find a value. And then finally, there's a backpropagation phase, which is where you take the value found from the rollout and you put that in appropriate places in the tree all the way up to the top node. So let's have a look at the algorithm for the first two phases. This is for tree traversal and for node expansion. So you start with S0, that's the initial state, being the current state. You then ask yourself, is it a leaf node? If it's not a leaf node, then you have to choose which child of the current state you're going to explore. And you do this by calculating the UCB1 value of each of the states, and then you choose the one that maximizes that value. So in other words, you take this formula, you calculate UCB1 for each of the child states, and then you select the node that maximizes that formula. You keep doing this and going round until you get to a leaf node in the tree. You then have to ask yourself, for the leaf node, how many times has it been sampled? If it's never been sampled before, you don't expand it. You simply do a rollout from there. However, if it has been sampled before, this is where you add new nodes into the tree. What you do is that for each available action from the current state, you add a new state to the tree, and then you let current be the first of those new child nodes, and then you do the rollout from this new child node. So the rollout process is fairly simple. It simply consists of taking the state that you got to at the end of your process here. And then if it's a terminal state, you simply return the value. Otherwise, you choose a random action from the available actions of that state. You simulate it. So you simulate the action on the current state, and that becomes the new current state, and you loop around forever until you get to a terminal state. When I draw it on the example, I'm going to notate it like this. So here's the state that you got to at the end of the tree. That's the leaf node. This is the random simulation down to a terminal state, and then this terminal state is going to have some value, say V equals 10, and I'm going to then use that as an estimate of what the value of that state is. So I'm now going to do a worked example showing you how this works. We're going to start with an initial state here, S0. I've written up the UCB1 formula here for you. So UCB1 of a given state is equal to the average value of that state plus 2 times the natural logarithm of the parent visits, that's n, over the number of visits of this node, all square rooted. I'm using 2 as my constant here in order to balance between the exploitation term, that's the value, and the exploration term, which is this value here. So we'll start with the initial state S0, and the first thing that I need to do is to add in the available actions from S0. They are A1 and A2, and I'm going to say that they lead to a state called S1. A state called S2, and I set up the total score and the number of visits for each of those, and that's what I'm going to use to calculate the average scores as we go along. So that's the initial state of the tree before we've done any iterations of the algorithm. I'm now going to do the first iteration of the algorithm. So I start by doing tree traversal. I start at the initial state, S0, and I then have to choose between these two child nodes. And the way that I choose is that I calculate the UCB1 value for this and the UCB1 value for this, and I then take whichever node maximizes that value. Now, because neither of these nodes have been visited yet, that means that this term here is infinite. So that means that the UCB value for both of these nodes is infinite. They both have the same value, so I'm just going to take them in numerical order. So I'm going to visit this one first. So I'm now at a leaf node. Since I'm at a leaf node, I have to ask, has it been visited or not yet? Well, it hasn't been visited yet, so therefore I don't expand it. So here, essentially what I'm doing is saying, is the current value for ni 0? If it is, I roll it out immediately. If it isn't, then I expand it, and then I select a node and roll it out. So I'm going to do a rollout from here. The rollout looks like this. So I choose random actions from S1 all the way down to a terminal state, which I'll denote like that. I'm going to say that the value of this is 20. So I'm now going to go into the fourth phase of the algorithm. That's the backpropagation phase. I take this value and I backpropagate it into the t values and the n values all the way up the tree. So I'm going to go, first of all, I'm going to visit S1, then I'm going to visit S0. So what I do is I change these values here. T is the total score, and that's now going to be 20. The number of visits is now 1, and similarly at the top level, the total number of visits is now 1, and the score, total score, is 20. The last thing that I do is forget about the rollout, just throw it away. And that's the end of the first iteration of the algorithm. The way that Monte Carlo Tree Search works is that you run it in a number of iterations. You can either run a fixed number of iterations, or you can run it until you're out of time, and it will then tell you which it thinks is the best action. So I'm now going to run the second iteration. I go back to the initial state, S0, and I now have to ask, which of these child nodes of S0 do I visit? And the way that I do that is I calculate the UCB1 score. So for this one, the UCB1 score is going to be the average value, that's 20, plus 2 times the natural logarithm of 1 divided by the number of visits, which is also 1. And for this one, the UCB1 score is equal to infinity because of that 0. So therefore, this is going to be the higher value, so we're going to visit this one first. In general, if you've got a node with n equals 0 and the other nodes have got an n greater than 0, you're going to choose the n equals 0 one first. So I'm now going to do my rollout from S2 because it's a leaf node with n equals 0. So let's do that. Let's say that the value of this one is equal to 10. So I now backpropagate that value. This is going to be 10. That's going to be 1. This is now going to be 30. And we have 2 visits at the top node. And the last thing that we do is get rid of the rollout. So that's the state of play after 2 iterations. We'll now do the third iteration. So, for the third iteration, we start again at the root node. We've now got a choice between these. We need to recalculate the UCB1 values because the n has changed here. So for this one, it's going to be 20, plus the value of 2 times the natural logarithm of 2, divided by 1. And for this one, the average value is 10 plus 2 times the natural logarithm of 2 divided by 1. And since I'm a human calculator, I can tell you that this calculates as 21.67, and this one calculates as 11.67. We choose the node that maximises the UCB1 score, so it's going to be that one. And the reason we're choosing it is essentially because it's got a higher score. In general, we choose nodes that have got higher scores, but we also prefer nodes that have been visited less. But because they've been visited the same amount of times here, we choose that one. So we've now got ourselves a new current. It's a leaf node, but it's already been visited. So this is the point where we do the node expansion. So this is the first node expansion of the algorithm. We find the available actions. I'll say they're A3 and A4. And we'll say that that leads to a state called S3 and a state called S4. And I set them up with T values of 0 and N values of 0. I now have to choose one of these two. They've got the same UCB1 value. It's infinite, so I'll take them simply in order of their number. So I'll take S3 first. I'm now going to do a rollout from S3 because it's a leaf node and it's not been visited before. So rollout from here to a value. And I'm going to say that the value of that rollout is 0. I'm now going to backpropagate that value of 0. Well, t doesn't change, but the n value here changes to 1. The t value here doesn't change, but that changes to 2. And the t value here doesn't change, but that changes to 3. So at the end of 3 iterations of the algorithm, this is the state of the tree. So we're now going to proceed with the fourth iteration. This is the last one I'm going to do. And then I'm going to pass it over to you to continue with the search in your assignment. So the fourth iteration goes like this. I've got to choose between S1 and S2. And I'm going to choose the one that maximises the UCB1 score. So I need to calculate afresh the UCB1 score of each. Well, the average value of this node is 10, 20 over 2. So that's the VI bar score. And then I've got to calculate the value of this. Well, it's 2 times the natural logarithm of 3 divided by the number of visits. So that's 2. And I can tell you that that comes out as 11.48. I also have to calculate the UCB1 score for this. The average value is the same, it's 10 divided by 1. And then the other term is going to be 2 times the natural logarithm of 3 all over 1, because it's only been visited once. And this comes out to being 12.10. So I look at the UCB1 scores. This has got 12.10, that's got 11.48, so that's the one I'm going to choose. So this is my new current node, that one there. So it's a leaf node, but it's already been visited, so I expand it. I'm going to say that A5 and A6 are the available actions, leading to state S5 and S6. They've both got to T of 0, N of 0 to start with. I now have to choose between them. They're the same, so therefore I just take them in numerical order. I do a rollout from here, and I'm going to say that the value of that rollout is going to be 14. So rolling out from S5 gave me 14. I now backpropagate that into the tree, so I'm going to do it here, here, and here. So that's now 1. That's now 14. This is now 2. And the total is going to be 24, adding on the 14 to the 10. And at the top level, the total is going to be 44, and the number of visits is now 4. So that completes the first four iterations of the algorithm. And if we were asked to stop at this point, the search would essentially say that A2 is the better action to take because it has a higher average value. What you're looking for is the overall job of the algorithm is to run for as long as it is allowed to and then return which it thinks is the better action. Here it thinks that A2 is the better action because it returns a better reward. So in the assignment, what I'm going to ask you to do is to continue this search and see if A2 is still the preferred action after another couple of iterations of the search.